Hey guys, my name is Hamrozi and today I'm gonna show you guys how to create vector footsteps with Inkscape 1.2 using the object marker technique. With this technique, you can create a footsteps in any directions with the same copy of the footsteps icon, whether it's right path or really curvy one. So yeah, let's get into it. So here we are on the Inkscape interface. Let's press 1 on the keyboard to zoom in 100%. And first of all, we create an ordinarily vertical line with this bezier curve tool, or by pressing B on the keyboard, or just click on the toolbar if you want to. And then click anywhere on the canvas, left clicking it, hold control and drag it down like this. You know, you can put any size you want, but I'm just gonna make sure it is 100 pixels in white. And under stroke style, make sure you know the size is just, you know, 1 pixels, and that's enough. And I'm just gonna select this ordinary line, vertical line, hold control and roll up your mouse wheel to zoom in. And then we're gonna add a path effects on this line. So go to the path effects, and on this path effects dialog, I'm just gonna press plus on the keyboard to edit, and I'm gonna add a called Powerstroke, like this. And the start cap is gonna be round, as well as the end cap is gonna be round as well, and the joints will be rounded as well. The smoothness will be 1, which is the maximum. And as you see, nothing happened because we don't actually, you know, edit one of these things, because we're gonna edit it with the notes tool by pressing N on your keyboard, or just click the toolbar. And as you see, there's 2 types of notes here. There's the gray one and the pink one. The pink one's gonna edit how thick the line you want it to be, as you see here. The middle part, the end part, as well as the start part, as you see. You know, it's like a basketball bat, pretty much. But what we do is that we're gonna curve it a little bit. But first, let's make sure it's gonna a bit shorter. I'm just gonna select this node over here, hold control, and drag it. Oh, so it looks shorter like this. And I'm just gonna tag the line in the middle of this object. You can't really see it, me either, because I don't know. Apparently, Inkscape doesn't show it. But if we just tag it like that. There you go, it's gonna rotate it like that, and just edit this pink node again, so it looks like a shoe sole, you can say. Yeah, I think this looks fine. Now let's just finalize it by going to the path, object to path. And now, as you see, there is a bunch of nodes that is unnecessary right now. I'm just gonna select, you know, all of them that is unnecessary, as you see. Like this, nope, not like that. Yeah, it looks pretty okay. You can make even better if you want to. I think it's okay like this. And now I'm just gonna add a rectangle. By using the rectangle tool on this toolbar, or press R on the keyboard to have it. I'm just gonna create an ordinary rectangle and make it, you know, in blue color like this. And it's just pretty thin like this. And just hold shift and drag it outwards on this arrow. So make sure it is, you know, even wider than the sole step itself, the shoe sole itself. So yeah. I'm just gonna select it once again until we have this kind of arrow. Just rotate it from that arrow so it looks like this. Or maybe just make it bigger, like that. Yeah. Now hold shift and click on the black object. Go to the path, difference, and the shoe sole is pretty much done. It's not really finished, but you know it's. Looks pretty much like how shoes looks in real life. I mean the shoe steps in real life, you know. And just I'm selecting once again and just rotate it. I think that's about right, like that. Like this. Just how, you know, in general, human choose directions in real life. Like that, I think this is, you know, pretty much how it looks. And now just select it once again. Press Control plus Shift. Actually, Control plus D to duplicate it. And just gonna make it over here. And just, we're gonna mirror this horizontally by pressing this icon. Or just press H on your keyboard if you want to. And yeah, let's just press it around here, I guess. So yeah, it looks like a step of, it's like a, you know, human footstep like that. It looks pretty good, right? And now we select both of them. And now go to the path union to unify them together. And now we're gonna make this object as a marker. But first, let's just rotate it like this, because we're gonna make the line horizontal later on. So go to the object to markers. It's gonna, you know, disappear because it's as a marker, not an object right now. So this is where the magic happens, to be honest. I like this part. So with the bezier curve tool, we're gonna create a horizontal line, left click it anywhere on canvas, hold control and just drag it here. And yeah, press enter on your keyboard. And now with the nodes tool, I'm gonna drag this straight line upward and this one downwards. And to make a curve like this, or you can just, you know, select the lines and use the handles. So it's way more flexible like this. Yeah, pretty good. Yeah, looking pretty good. You know, in on pan around on the canvas, I'm just gonna, you know, hold down the mouse wheel just to pan around like this, just for information. And now we're gonna go to the fill and stroke tab, and the width, make sure it's just, you know, 1 pixel, it's all enough. And here we are on the markers, 1, 2, 3, there's 3 drop down. I'm just gonna select the second one, which is in the middle, and select it, and we have our step on the top of this column, this dialog. You know, we have other stuff like a arrow like this, even there is scissors, so a bunch of times pencil there. So we're gonna select this object. You see, that's our step that we make before, but as you see on the canvas, on the line itself, there's nothing happen. That's because there is no nodes in this middle of this line. There is only just 2 nodes, which is the start as well as the end of it. So we, in order to markers to work, there is to be a node in the middle of the line. So let's select both of them and select a node in the middle of them. Insert new nodes into selected segments. Left clicking on that, as you see, we have our step, which is gigantic, to be honest. So let's just scale out, make the line bigger. Hold control and roll down your mouse wheel to zoom out, and hold control plus shift and click this arrow and move it outward. So it looks like this. As you see, the step is in the middle of the line. I'm just gonna make the line in the middle of the canvas there. So like I said, in order to markers to work, there is needs to be a node in the middle of the line. So we only have 1 node, which means there is only 1 icon, 1 footstep. So let's add more by selecting off the line and make new nodes in the middle of the new nodes, in the middle of the nodes that we have. As you see, if I add up more and more, there is more and more steps going on. So yeah, that's looking pretty good. You know, we can make the line, you know, even closer like this. Hold shift and just drag it inward little by little to make the footstep like even. Yeah, that's looking pretty good. You know, you can change the size of it. Maybe 90, like that. Yeah, that's looking pretty good, to be honest. You can even change the orientations like this, you know, as you see. But I think this, you know, this one is orient along the path is fine, you know. I'm just gonna, I think this one is okay. And to finalize the footsteps, I'm just gonna select them. So go to the path, stroke to path. And if I control plus U a couple of times, there become an individual object. So I'm just gonna take this this curvy line, step that aside, press delete on your keyboard to delete that, and select all of these footsteps, go to the path, union to finalize them together. And now they are become a one object. So we can change the color into red, into blue. I'm just gonna change it into like 10% gray because it looks like a footstep of on a snow, as you see, with the contrast of the white backgrounds. Yeah, I think that's pretty good. Also, what's cool about this this marker feature is that if we create another line with this bezier curve, I'm just gonna create a line like this. I'm just gonna add just like before, as you see, it's gonna be an exact copy of that icon that we have created before. So that looks really, really cool, right? I'm just gonna add a bunch of icon again, right? That looks fine, but the downside of this technique is that if we don't have a notes that is really, really, you can say not really in a good formations, which means if the icon is just too much, it's gonna create like a bunch of repeated icon, which is unnecessary. So you might want to delete some of them and make a good line like this. Also make sure the direction of the line, it's pretty, you know, pretty good, you can say, in terms of flow with the line. So the footsteps doesn't look jittery like a fake footstep like that. So yeah, so that's one of the technique on how to create a vector footsteps with Inkscape. After this, hopefully you can create even better vector footsteps. That's it from me, guys. Don't forget to suggest any tutorial in the future, and as always, thank you for your time.